When humans interrupt, contaminate, and disrupt the water cycle, we are left with extremes. Forests are clear-cut, wetlands drained, and vast landscapes plowed. These actions disrupt the water cycle. Barren land is created where forests once stood. Hard surfaces, roads, and buildings where once was water. On the hot and dry soil, the water can no longer infiltrate, so it leaves quickly, no longer able to replenish the groundwater. From the excess runoff, rivers flood their banks, damaging infrastructure. So the rivers are dredged deeper, lowering the water level in the whole landscape. The exposed and hardened ground absorbs more heat, resulting in rising temperatures and hot air. As coastal humidity tries to move inland, the hot air pushes back, causing the pressure to build. When the pressure finally overcomes, its power is destructive, more intense, with less regularity. A cycle of extreme drought followed by extreme weather events. When it rains, it floods, and the stormwater runs quickly downhill, resulting in flooding and erosion, leaving destruction and drought in its wake. All the while, the water table is sinking and the water quality declining. Springs go dry, the rivers run low and heat up, less fish, less life, the ecosystem begins to collapse. Humans drill for groundwater to irrigate, draining the last remaining reserves of water in the earth. Drought becomes frequent, wells start to go dry, and crops begin to fail as stress and competition increase. Eventually, the fires come and the landscape burns. Desert is all that remains from a once lush and thriving landscape. This is a cycle of extremes and destruction, leading to water scarcity, food scarcity, poor water quality, disease, famine, war, stress, and angst for the future. As the Earth's biomes desertify, the climate becomes increasingly inhospitable and erratic. This watershed death spiral makes life harder for all of Earth's inhabitants.